Developers of the Disney video game Epic Mickey used many elements of Disneyland as inspiration for the setting of the game. They also included one very special setting.
When we decided that the game was going to be set in a version of Disneyland, I knew that we had to include Walt's apartment. I mean, it's legendary. It's a part of park lore.
Walt's apartment is preserved in exactly the way that he left it, which is really amazing. There was an antique style lamp up in the corner, and Walt would always turn that on to let the cast members know when he was actually in his apartment. It is replaced by a Christmas tree during the holidays. Other times, it is always lit to remind us that Walt's present is still here today. And you all are going to get to tour it. This is a very special treat.
There was a crowd of reporters in Walt Disney's small apartment, but we got a chance to look around.
He spent a lot of time here, even during construction, was here early in the morning, late at night. And to drive all the way to Holmby Hills, where his house was, and come back in the morning was just too stressful. So he and his Imagineers realized early on that he needed a place to stay, that he could be here when needed.
The apartment was designed by Emil Curie, a set decorator for many Disney films and the decorator for Main Street. Walt also spent time in the apartment after Disneyland opened. There was a small kitchenette where the original grilled cheese sandwich maker that Walt used still sits. The phonograph was a gift from Walt to his wife Lillian, as were several other elements in the roughly 500-square-foot apartment.
We were respectful, let's just say, of the place, so don't expect to be using your paint and thinner and stuff on this location. But you can actually visit this in the game, and it's. I thought it was going to be the only way I'd ever actually get inside, you know, but here we are.
Mark Eades reporting for OCRegister.com.